It was a disappointing week for equities with the single biggest daily loss of the year as investors focused more on growing concerns with Europe's weak growth versus corporate earnings and economic news. The Dow moved into negative territory for the first time this year, and this was the worst week for the S&P 500 and NASDAQ since May of 2012. The Dow closed down nearly 3% for the week to settle at 16,544. The NASDAQ tumbled, losing just over 4%, closing at 4,276, and the S&P 500 lost slightly over 3% to end at 1,906. Gap Incorporated shares tumbled this week after the company announced that CEO Glenn Murphy will retire and step down in February. Under Murphy's watch, the retailer shut down 600 stores, more than doubled its share price and shareholder return, and considerably expanded online and overseas markets. Recently, Janney Capital Markets analysts downgraded the company's shares from neutral from buy. Gap Inc. lost over 13% and closed at $36.34 a share. Amazon announced plans to open its first brick-and-mortar store in Manhattan, just in time for this year's holiday season. The experimental store will operate as a small warehouse holding limited inventory. The store may also host tech showcases for items such as Kindle e-readers, Fire iPhones, and Fire TVs. A New York customer may order an online item and then pick it up that very same day. That's your market report for the week. I'm Bruce Heron. Have a great weekend.